Students, I am going to teach you the poem Death Be Not Proud. This poem is also written by John Donne, the metaphysical poet. This poem is a sonnet and appeared in a collection or a volume of sonnets named Holy Sonnets. This sonnet was number 10 sonnets in that volume. This poem is a challenge by the poet to death. Actually, he personifies death. He addresses death directly as a person in this poem and challenges him that he is not so powerful. He is not dreadful as people think about it. The beginning tells us the same thing. The poem is a sonnet, as I have told you earlier, and the sonnet has two parts. First is octave and second is sestave. In octave, the poet tells what are the parts as people think of death and what actually it is, what actually he is. He says, "Death, be not proud, though some have called thee mighty and dreadful, for thou art not so. For those whom thou thinkest thou dost overthrow. Die not, poor death, for yet canst thou kill me from rest and sleep, which but thy pictures be. Much pleasure then from thee much more must flow, and soonest out best men with thee do go." The first line, he addresses death as a person. Death, be not proud. Don't feel. Be proud on yourself. As people say that you are mighty, you are powerful, you are dreadful, people get afraid of you. For thou art not so. But in reality or actuality, it is not so. You are not so powerful. People should not feel fear of you. For those whom thou thinkest thou does overthrow. The word thou here stands for you. In old English, writers generally used this word for you. Die not, poor death, or yet canst thou kill me. He challenges and says, the people to whom you think that you have killed, the actual thing is that you had not killed them. You had not killed them. And even you cannot kill the poet. You cannot kill me, the poet says. From rest and sleep. And he says that rest and sleep, which are the miniatures of death, which but thy pictures be, they are similar. They give the same pleasure as you give, but more than you, he says. Much pleasure then from thee much more must flow, and soonest our best men with thee do go. He says that some heroic personalities or the people who did some great deeds here in this world and died in their young age, it was not the power of death that it had killed them, but they had done some great deeds, so to get rest to their body, for their body, or to provide rest to them, their soul departed and their body lied in their graves to get rest. It was nothing about death that it had killed them. Rest of their bones and souls delivery. Thou art slave to fate, chance, kings, and desperate men, and does with poison, war and sickness dwell. And in cestate, he says that the power of death is not so great, but the things, there are many other things which can provide the same relaxation, the same rest as death gives. Thou art slave to fate. He underestimates or he makes it inferior by saying that you are the slave of fate. You are not powerful. You cannot kill anyone. Chance, kings, and desperate men, and does with poison. The people who are very desperate, they can kill themselves. And sickness can also do the same thing as you do. This can be done with poison also. The desperate man can do it with poison or poppy. And poppy or chance can make a sleep as well. And the plants of poppy and chance can also give the same rest, the same enjoy as you give. Because sleep is a short form or a miniature of death. As death gives rest and relaxation to body and soul, in the same way, these plants give rest. Their intoxication, their toxic effect gives relaxation to body. And better than thy stroke, why swellest thou them? And this relaxation is better than your effect, better than